Welcome to my classroom. I am Nisli. In this video, I shall try to explain the local potentials. Local potentials have many different names. You can come across all of these in the books. They can be called local potentials, graded potentials, passive potentials, or electrotonic potentials. They all mean the same. There are some types of local potentials, and all of them are produced by mechanically or ligand-gated ion channels. So the receptor potentials that form at our sensory neurons are one type of local potential. The end plate potential that is formed at the neuromuscular junction is another type of local potential. At a neuronal synapse, in the postsynaptic neuron, some local potentials are formed. They are called excitatory postsynaptic potentials or inhibitory postsynaptic potentials. Local potentials also form during the conduction of an action potential. For example, in a myelinated nerve, there's an electrotonic conduction under the myelin until the next node of Ranvier. In non-myelinated neurons, there's an electrotonic conduction to the neighboring area just next to where an action potential is formed. To explain the local potentials, I am going to use the neuron that I have explained in the resting membrane potential video, the neuron number 4. In this neuron, resting membrane potential was minus 70 millivolt, potassium nerve potential was minus 80 millivolt, sodium nerve potential was plus 61 millivolt. In the same video, I have explained that at the resting conditions, there are many leak potassium channels, which are always open, and very few sodium leak channels on the cell membrane. These are producing the resting membrane potential. In another video where I discussed the ion currents in cells with constant resting membrane potential, we discussed the same cell. At this cell, we talked about a potassium efflux from the open leak channels that are always open and a sodium influx from the sodium leak channels. The number in this discussion, we learned that the number of positive charges leaving the cell by the efflux of potassium is equal to the number of positive charges that enter the cell by the influx of sodium. There was a balance of charge movement, and the two were equal, and the resting membrane potential was constant. In this cell, a small electrochemical driving force is coming together with a big conductance for potassium to produce potassium efflux. A big electrochemical force is coming together with a smaller conductance for sodium to produce sodium influx. And we had an equilibrium at that cell. Now let us start talking about local potentials, local potential forming. If ligand or mechanically gated potassium channels open, this balance will change toward the benefit of potassium efflux. There will be a greater potassium conductance, and the same electrochemical force is going to result in a bigger potassium efflux, and this is going to overrate the sodium influx. When there is a net positive charge, loss by the exit of potassium, potassium efflux is going to bring the membrane potential towards more negative values. A condition like this is called hyperpolarization. This is the first type of local potential. Another local potential type can be produced by the opening of ligand or mechanically gated sodium channels. This is now going to change the balance condition toward the sodium influx. Sodium influx is going to become more important, and there will be a net input of positive charges to the cell. What happens when we have sodium influx from the ligand or mechanically gated sodium channels? the entry of positive charges, net positive charges to the cell, is going to change the membrane potential towards less negative value, and this condition is called depolarization. If you have noticed, I call hyperpolarization or depolarization a membrane potential. We are no longer at the resting membrane potential. We need to be careful about this. So, we see here that sodium influx is producing depolarization, potassium influx is producing hyperpolarization. You are going to remember from another video about the ion channels that every ion coming together with its ion channels tries to bring the membrane potential towards its own NaNs. So here we can see that sodium influx is trying to bring, it's not able to bring exactly to the NaNs, but it is trying to bring the membrane potential towards the NaNs potential of sodium. And potassium influx is trying to bring the membrane potential towards the NaNs potential of potassium. If we talk about chloride, the last piece of local potentials belong to chloride. A chloride influx makes a similar effect as a potassium efflux. Because chloride is negatively charged, entry of chloride to the cell is going to produce extra negativity and hyperpolarization. The effect of chloride in the local potentials and on the resting membrane potential will be explained in detail in another video. It's a little bit more complex, so we need another video for it. So I tried to summarize simply the local potentials. I hope it has been useful. Thank you for watching.